I'd just like to thank you all for letting me come up and speak, and I'm very excited about being here tonight. I'd like to just emphasize that from my perspective, the mosaic that I created has a very important message. It's a secular message. It's being delivered by a cultural icon, the Virgin of Guadalupe. She's in a position on a surfboard, of course, as you know. But the message is to save the ocean. This is a very important ecological message. I think it's an important part of our community. The ocean is a big draw for our tourism, as well as just a lifesaver for all of us. So I think that it's important that, from my perspective, if we can put the mosaic back up in this particular park that was identified earlier, it gives plenty of room for the mosaic to be viewed easily. It's in a safe location for people to view, as other people have already pointed out. I have some very important supporters here in Encinitas, including the Mizell Family Foundation, which is offering a matching grant for any funds that the Surfing Madonna Oceans Project raises for the erection of the wall for the mosaic to be replaced, to be placed on in that park, so that there's no cost to the city is our goal. And the other thing is that in spite of requests from other cities, I want the mosaic to stay in Encinitas. It is intended to be a gift to the people of Encinitas. Although I'm very grateful to the other municipalities that have approached us. Also, I just have to thank the Paul Hastings group and also Anton Gerschler, the lawyers who have really helped me get through this whole process. And Martin Garrick, his support is very much appreciated. And just want to thank the council for considering this gift of art.
And your name for the record was?
Mark Patterson.
Thank you, Mark.
I should have said that at the beginning.
Thank you very much. We have Councilmember Barth.
Yes. Thank you. Well, it's been a long time to get to this point, and I'm glad that we are finally here, because I absolutely support this, and that's not just a labor of love, but it is an extremely generous gift to our community. You know, I am not a lawyer, but my opinion, like Mr. Kranz, I'm Catholic, I'm Mexican. To me, it's a cultural icon. It doesn't, you know, the Guadalupe is part of my cultural tradition, and I certainly, you know, see it as that. But it's such a mix of things, and it's more like, I always say the missions, they are Catholic churches, but they are part of our history. We teach it in public school, fourth grade. What parent hasn't agonized over building that mission model out of, you know, whatever, shredded wheat and sugar cubes. So that does not make those religious items, just because they are replicas of missions. And so I think this definitely transcends that. And the Madonna, that's pre-Columbian. If you look in cultures, and particularly in Latin America, you see Mother Earth, Mother Ocean. It brings all of that's the culture and the history of this area, as well as the whimsy of Encinitas with surfing and also the environmentalists. This is truly a strong environmental community. So again, and then you represented that all by using a technique of being a mosaic, where you took pieces, parts, glass, stone, ceramics, just like you took parts of culture, parts of history, parts of the community to make something else. And by using mosaic as opposed to paint, you recreated that theme yet again of bringing different things together to create something so beautiful. And I actually saw it probably about 3 or 4 hours after you put it up, only I didn't know that it was 3 or 4 hours after you put it up, and I stopped my car and ran over and took a picture on my phone and sent it off to everybody and said, "Do you know who put this up?" And so it's been a long trip, but it's been a very rewarding one. Thank you, Mark.